ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਸੈਗਮੈਂਟ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੇਰਾ ਸਾਥ ਦੇਣਗੇ ਐਂਟੋਨੀਨਾ, ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਇੱਕ CHP ਹਨ, ਸਰਟੀਫਾਈਡ ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨਲ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟੀਸ਼ਨਰ ਨੇ, ਅਤੇ ਇਹ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਦੱਸਣਗੇ ਕਿ ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜੇਕਰ ਕੋਈ ਜਾਣਾ ਚਾਹੇ, ਯਾਨੀ ਕਿ ਐਜ਼ ਅ ਕੈਰੀਅਰ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਅਡੋਪਟ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੇ, ਤਾਂ ਉਸ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ. ਸੋ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਐਂਟੋਨੀਨਾ ਤੋਂ ਕਿ ਕੀ ਹਨ ਇਸ ਫੀਲਡ ਦੇ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਕੀ ਸਕੋਪ ਹੈ. ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ.
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ.
ਸੋ ਫਸਟ ਆਫ ਆਲ, ਯੂ ਆਰ ਅ ਸਰਟੀਫਾਈਡ ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨਲ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟੀਸ਼ਨਰ. ਸੋ ਟੈਲ ਅਸ, ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਟਾਕ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨ ਐਸ ਸੱਚ, ਯੂ ਨੋ, what all do you do?
Great question, because there's so many things and directions that you can take once you are graduated. Mm-hmm. There's definitely many schools, so you can go to a school that will cover nutrition in several months, or some nutritional schools call themselves schools when they only teach for a couple of weekends. And then, of course, there is more complex or more, I guess, the education that is better, right, accredited, and mm-hmm. has a year or 2 year full-time programs. There's also 4 year degrees. So it really depends on what the individual has chosen. And then as well, within nutrition, it's such a big subject. There's mm-hmm. so many things that you can narrow into. Do you want to work with digestive issues? Do you want to work with hormonal issues? Do you want to work with postpartum or you know, cancers or diabetes? Right. It's really the nutritionist will choose a specific direction, or specifically cater to women or men in business who have fatigue, adrenal fatigue and things like that, or mm-hmm. focus on thyroid. So once they choose the niche, then they usually will cover in that. And of course, many also choose to be a holistic and just look and have approach to all of the diseases, but maybe not in that much
intense, in depth
approach. Yeah.
Okay.
But what we would do, it would really depend again on the individual. There are individuals who just need very little help and the guidance.
Right.
How to eat, how to change their lifestyle for the better. Mm-hmm. It could be a New Year resolution. I want to lose 20 pounds and I want to feel more energy.
Right.
And that will be, well, of course, depending on the person. Every single person is individual. For some person, it will be harder to achieve the goals than for another. So the depth and the amount of work that's required will be different for individuals. So for some person, within 1 hour education and making a few tweaks because they're already on the right way could set them on the path. With others, you might have to meet with weekly or biweekly and write up a program. If they have absolutely no idea how to eat or how to tell apart what's good for them, then you go much deeper. And then, of course, a lot of times many of us, and myself included, we will use clinical approach, where we'll do a series of tests and then understand the exact underlying cause based on actual chemistry and then go from there.
Mm-hmm. You have used two important phrases in your talk, and one is how to eat. Mm-hmm. Do you mean to say people do not know how to eat?
Yeah, that's a very good point, and I would say yes.
Okay.
Many people don't. We used to.
Right.
We used to be very close to our environment, to mm-hmm. our nature. We used to grow our own food. Today, as you know, there are many students in high school that don't even know. Or, you know, whenever you have, you know, Jamie Oliver, even I've seen some programs in which he'll go to mm-hmm. a North American school, and kids do not know how the vegetables end up there, or what they're called, or they've never seen them or touched them. So we have a generation, or at least last several generations, in where they grow up on mac and cheese and mm-hmm. fast food restaurants and eating processed packaged food that has pictures, but they've never really been in the garden. They've never really participated in cutting and making a salad mm-hmm. or making a juice or a smoothie or doing anything from whole foods.
Right.
So yes, we do need a lot of education, and some mm-hmm. people need more work than others.
So when you say there are various options which are available depending upon what you want now mm-hmm. in the market, those things are available. But also, how much awareness is increasing over the years? You have been in this field for a long period, and your journey is from a corporate sector to a nutritional health practitioner. It's a complete change in your career, you know, you mm-hmm. took. But when we talk about the awareness as such, what are you finding? What is your observation? Are people getting aware of what they're consuming, or is it still the same kind of mentality which mm-hmm. exists?
You've made a great observation yourself, because you're right. There is a big awareness, and people start asking questions mm-hmm. and people are curious and reading a lot more.
Right.
And we see across the board, pretty much any age group, we see people coming to us, listening to videos, reading more, whether it's health magazines, even in a lot of times you, I guess, will notice is whenever there is a demand, the supply will follow.
Right.
And so I think even just by judging on supply, how much, how many there are meditation studios and yoga studios and health food stores and juicing places, right?
Right.
And people talking about it, and the magazines are talking about it, and television talking about it. We all speak about you know, elements or even foods that we've never heard about for the last, you know, 20 years ago. Everybody's talking about goji berries and coconut milk or this and that. So it's become such mainstream, you know, it's almost fashionable and trendy right now to be in this healthy environment or learning more and keeping up with everybody is an evolution. So I do think that we are moving along and moving moving forward with understanding of nutrition, what the body really needs and how to achieve it. And
okay, but on the other hand, while the environment, what we are talking about is still the same, there is no change. Rather, we are finding that pollution is increasing, more and more chemicals in the environment. So keeping all these things, when we talk about, like you said, you know, children even do not know, they haven't seen a raw vegetable on their own, and they have not touched or been in the garden. So it's a big, you know, drastic change which has to be brought in the thinking of the people, and especially the younger generation. So you go to schools also and you talk to youngsters also. Tell us, how are the youngsters absorbing this? Is it the mid-aged or the youngsters also who are coming forward and understanding this? Because they want logic for everything. And when you say to them about something, with Google these days, they just type and they have an alternative for that. So how do you address to this issue?
Yeah, great question. I do love speaking to young generation. I speak a lot at 10, 11 graders. School was 10, 11 graders. And in North Vancouver and West Vancouver schools, and they're amazing.
Right.
Students and the teenagers, they're open. They may have some skeptical beliefs or, you know, ideas, or they might have heard something from their parents, but they're very open-minded, and they always have thought leaders. So there will always be a few students in class who have been telling them all along, and then all of a sudden I come, and they just blossom there, and they just feel so excited. And I think kids, if you really break it down, they really understand, and they answer it really well. They have less barriers to cross, so I think they learn faster than adults. And yeah, and I think that's exactly why, because I think our this new generation notices how much more polluted the world is for them, how much more they're exposed to, how many more, you know, how many more of them are sick, how many children in school, and you know, even talking about elementary, we have a lot of children on the medications, and whether if we're talking, we can talk about psychiatric medications or you know, allergy medications, or any kind of digestive, you know, immunosuppressant medications, or they're sick a lot. So they see there's something's wrong, and and they're the ones who are, I think, actually maybe moving us forward, because they come to their parents and ask, "Mom, Mom, this is what I've read, or this is what I've heard, or this is what my girlfriend led me to try. Can we buy this?" Or you're, you know, they're kind of actually driving the decision making in the household.
Okay.
A lot of the times, not all the time. Sometimes it's the parents who come say and say, "I want better for my child, and this medication hasn't helped, so I'm going to look into something else, and I'm going to see what I can do."
You talked about sickness. Sickness is increasing. You know, children are, especially children are much more immune now, not immune, but susceptible to diseases, and especially during the flu season or allergies. So these are the issues which are increasing in a big way. And of course, as you said very rightly, that nutrition is a major factor. If we keep a control on our nutrition, all these issues, challenges can be faced. In our programs, as we discuss, we would like to talk on specific topics in the future. Thank you very much for your time, for being here. Thanks for your time.
My pleasure.
Thank you. So, ਅੱਜ ਅਸੀਂ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕੀਤੀ ਉਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਐਂਟੋਨੀਨਾ ਨੇ ਦੱਸਿਆ ਜਦੋਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੁੱਛਿਆ ਕਿ ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨ ਦੀ ਜਦੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਉਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੀ ਸਕੋਪ ਹੈ। ਨਿਊਟ੍ਰੀਸ਼ਨ ਯਾਨੀ ਕਿ ਖਾਣ ਪੀਣ ਜੋ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਪਰਿਵਰਤਨ ਆ ਗਿਆ। ਅੱਜ ਇਸ ਕੰਜ਼ਿਊਮਰਿਜ਼ਮ ਦੇ ਜ਼ਮਾਨੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਗਏ ਉਹ ਜ਼ਮਾਨੇ ਜਦੋਂ ਕਿ ਸਬਜ਼ੀਆਂ ਫਰੈਸ਼ ਮਿਲਦੀਆਂ ਸੀ, ਪੈਸਟੀਸਾਈਡ ਤੋਂ ਰਹਿਤ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਸੀ, ਔਰਗੈਨਿਕ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਸੀ। ਅੱਜ ਹਰ ਚੀਜ਼ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਕੰਜ਼ੰਪਸ਼ਨ ਵਧ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਉਸਦਾ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਵਧਾਈ ਜਾ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ। ਉਸ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਦਾ ਉਪਯੋਗ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਉਸ ਵੱਲ ਧਿਆਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ, ਪਰ ਸਿਰਫ ਫੋਕਸ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਉਸਦੀ ਡਿਮਾਂਡ ਪੂਰੀ ਹੋ ਸਕੇ। ਸੋ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਅੱਜ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਵਿਅਕਤੀ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਐਜ਼ ਅ ਕੈਰੀਅਰ ਵੀ ਅਡੋਪਟ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਇਹ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ 'ਤੇ ਡਿਪੈਂਡ ਕਰਦਾ। ਇੱਕ ਘੰਟੇ ਦਾ ਵੀ ਕੋਰਸ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ 4 ਸਾਲ ਦਾ ਵੀ ਇੱਕ ਕੋਰਸ ਹੈ ਜਿਸ ਨੂੰ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਅਡੋਪਟ ਕਰਕੇ ਨਾ ਸਿਰਫ ਆਪਣੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੋਈ ਪਰਿਵਰਤਨ ਲਿਆਉਣਾ ਚਾਹੋ ਬਲਕਿ ਐਜ਼ ਅ ਕੈਰੀਅਰ ਵੀ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਅਡੋਪਟ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੈਗੇ ਹੋ। ਉਸ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਸਮਾਜ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਤੇਜ਼ੀ ਨਾਲ ਪਰਿਵਰਤਨ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਹੈ। ਨੌਜਵਾਨ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਜਦੋਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਬਾਤਾਂ ਪਰ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਈਜ਼ੀ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋਣ ਲਈ ਤਿਆਰ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਨੇ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਜੂਝ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ, ਮਾਨਸਿਕ ਤੌਰ 'ਤੇ ਸਿਹਤ ਪੱਖ ਤੋਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਬਲਮਸ ਆ ਰਹੀਆਂ ਨੇ। ਸੋ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਆਓ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਖਾਣ ਪੀਣ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਤਬਦੀਲੀ ਲਿਆਈਏ, ਚੰਗਾ ਖਾਣ ਪੀਣ ਰੱਖੀਏ ਜਿਸ ਨਾਲ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਿਹਤਮੰਦ ਰਹਿ ਸਕੀਏ।